you look like an astronaut. The colleagues who are working in this environment, they move like ballet. They move like this because in order to have the best cells, you need to be very, very fast, not make mistakes, but not hectic. And that's what the top people do. I'm Simone, I'm the head of production at a cell therapy site at Novartis. I'm responsible for the clean rooms and the people producing cell therapies. My typical day at work starts quite early in the morning. In cell therapy, we would take your T cells, we would freeze them, it gets shipped to us, then we thaw it, we grow them, we give them food, we keep them warm. We put the virus on it, and that's where the science fiction part starts. That virus puts the right piece of gene into the T cells, and you get the cells injected into you, and it's now eating the cancer. I think the process is fascinating. Working with live things is very different, and the recognition that you have live people cells in your hands creates a very different work environment.
I have a large group of people reporting to me, and most of them are men. I do encourage them to bring their whole selves to work as fathers, as caregivers, or wherever they are in their lives.
I don't think I've ever seen a problem that I didn't think was interesting and worth solving. And if I remember back what I started solving problems, it actually comes maybe very traditional. I like to sew, and I can fix a sewing machine. So when the first equipment came in science, I wasn't afraid of them because I can take apart an old Bernina sewing machine and fix it again.
Growing up in Switzerland, there were almost no female role models in science. Part of that journey was to be told that girls aren't good at math, I shouldn't do science. I was like, yeah.
I don't care.